That's so fast. I wanted to get into it a little bit more. That's fine. All right. Welcome to... What are we doing today? What did I say? We're going to make some lists today of things that we find really underappreciated. Now, I did make mine into a top five list. If you've ever watched any of our videos before, I like top five lists. Did you guys make a list out of it or just putting things as these are underappreciated in a box?
Mine's a list. I don't have reasons, but I can come up with reasons on the spot.
Probably a reason why you said it, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Nora, you have a list?
Yeah. And me and Addie got a list.
Addie has a list. Is it the same list or is it separate?
Same, but we came up with it together.
Oh, you guys are thinking the same way.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Okay. Underrated. The term is often used to describe something, movie, book, musician, athlete, that is considered to be high quality, to be of higher quality or value than it is typically recognized for. Underappreciated. This term is more general and can be applied to various situations or individuals. It means not receiving the full level of recognition, acknowledgement, or gratitude. So the way that I looked at it as things that maybe are... could be popular, but not appreciated enough.
That could be popular?
Yes.
I have
so
like,
for I have one that's more of like an outside looking in, like it's maybe underappreciated, but it's not. It's okay, so my first one, this one isn't on my list, but it just it was on the outside looking into my list, was being able to skip commercials. I think that's underappreciated.
Yeah. Like skipping ads on YouTube.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah, that's a good
commercials,
one.
Advertisements.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or even like being able to record something on DVR and fast forwarding through commercials.
Ooh,
I
DVR.
Didn't grow up with that.
That sounds old.
DVR is old now?
Yeah.
I suppose everything's is
DVD.
Like no.
It's off of Wi-Fi now.
So it's on
streaming is the word you guys are looking for here.
Did DVD Plus? Come after DVR?
No, DVD came after VHS. Who
VHS
can tell me what
like
VHS
those blocks.
Is?
Yeah, I know what VHS is. I'm pretty.
No,
we have a bunch still.
Into the mic.
I'll hear a Spotify ad and it'll be like, have you ever listened to a cassette tape or like a VHS or something like that? So it's like all like old terms.
Cassette is just audio though.
But that's.
Video
you know what
is
I mean.
VHS. Yeah, those are old.
That's
yeah.
like when in the olden days somebody would make a tape for you, a playlist.
A tape, yeah.
Ew.
So I had, before we get into our list, oh, I used to have a really like Uptown CD player
CD.
That had dual cassettes in it. So
Whoa.
I could play a cassette and record it on the other one.
Wow.
So that's where the original mixtape came from. If you ever hear the word mixtape, was off
gotcha.
Of that. So I could record a song by Counting Crows and then stop it and then play another one.
Beatles.
So yeah, Beatles.
I was trying to do
okay.
the old one.
Gosh.
So yeah, so we're
okay.
we're old here. So underappreciated. I might yell at some of your lists. I'm almost certain I will probably.
Okay.
I'm gonna say that's
you
underrated.
You definitely will yell at mine. You love to
probably.
Argue.
Probably. Okay. Okay. Who wants to start?
Can I start?
Yeah. Are you gonna list all of them or just one at a time?
One at a time.
Okay. Make sure you give me reasons though.
Okay. I'm gonna start strong with Matt Schrank.
Underappreciated.
Okay.
I do.
Suck up.
He does.
Suck up. Suck up.
He does so much
Suck
for our
up.
School.
I don't even think you really need to explain it.
Okay, bring yourself back down to earth real quick.
I appreciate that. I had to change my list now.
Now you can't yell at hers.
No, he can still. I'll allow
I'm
him
not,
to.
I'm not going to now, but thank you.
I should,
really
what
nice.
Is this one? Can I do?
That's these
well,
are all songs. If you want sounds, you got
to I didn't
go
like
first
rank them from
like,
top to last.
That's fine.
I kind of just put
just
them in a random
them,
order.
Yeah.
yeah.
We should have that be a sound.
That'd be a good one. Okay, what do you got?
Angel.
Give me one. Into the microphone, Cassidy.
So my first one is getting rid of a stuffy nose.
Getting rid of blowing your nose, like if it's stuffed
like,
up.
No, like so say like you have like a cold or something, and then
oh.
like you have it for like a week, and then like when it finally goes away, like the feeling
you're
of
like on a Tuesday
actually breathing.
That's a good one.
That is good.
That's a good one. I like that one.
That,
that is underappreciated,
really
but you don't really...
It's the first thing I saw on Google. So.
I was just going to say, I believe if you Google that, underappreciated items, that would be one. Maya, what do you have?
I have cleaning, because like the feeling after picking up, like cleaning up your house is really good.
That
like
would be...
Like mopping your house and then like sweeping it too.
Nobody
picking
wants to clean,
bedroom.
But it's an underappreciated feeling once it is clean and after
yeah.
you're done with it. Absolutely.
I
like
just
that one.
Cleaned my room for the first time in like 4 months.
Exactly.
That's a good
the
one.
Best
I really
feeling
like that
in
one.
The world.
It's amazing. And then I can just go home and relax.
My room
and be like, oh, my room's so clean. You're muted.
It is terrible.
Your what? Room is bad?
My room. It looks like a tornado went through it.
You should see my room before I cleaned it. It was yikes.
I wanted to yell at you guys for your list, and so far, pretty good.
Yeah,
let's have
just
Nora
wait.
And Addie go. What, you got one?
Yeah, it's really good. No, I'm going to do mine. I'm going to do mine. I think, like, history and all the world wars is really underappreciated. Because, like, think about it. If we didn't have that, then our country wouldn't be the way that it is.
Okay.
Nobody watching, can hear you.
I think watching documentaries, like, about that stuff is so cool.
Yeah. Documentaries, underappreciated.
So is it documentaries or
no,
is it the
actual
war? No,
it's like history, world wars, all that stuff.
So people underappreciate the war or what people did during the war?
What people did during the war and what came after it.
Okay. Yeah, can't argue with that one. Okay, my number five is Sarah Bareilles.
Who is that?
A singer. I think she's underappreciated.
Well, I can't.
You guys don't know her at all?
I can't
no,
tell if I
never
don't know
heard
her.
Of her.
Maybe she's underrated.
Probably.
I think she has a wonderful voice, and she's in a lot of other guys' songs. No, she's like 2000.
Oh, she's probably an old lady.
2005.
Is she still alive?
Yeah, she's still alive.
She's still alive. Elvis.
How old do you think I am?
Underappreciated.
Sarah Bareilles, I think, has a wonderful voice, and I really like all her songs. Let's see. The album that I really like, you've heard of Love Song. I didn't write you a love song.
No, no.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Wait, keep singing.
One?
Yeah, I know that one.
I don't know the words.
Why are you a teacher and not a teacher?
I can really listen.
Yeah, that one.
That's what you sound like. I don't know what that's.
That's what I sound like?
Voice yeah. Right now.
I know, right? I didn't write you
a song. No, that one's. That
or America's Got Talent.
Or Brave or Gravity.
Brave.
2013 was the album that I really like. I Choose You. That's a really good one.
Wait, like the I Wanna See You Be Brave.
Yeah, that one.
Oh!
Oh, you're mocking my
she's
voice.
Like a
that's by her?
Quite honestly.
Huh?
That's by Sorelli Rue.
This one?
I thought that was by Rachel Play.
Oh, maybe that. I'm that's thinking the wrong one.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Heard this one, right? Turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug. That one? You can be the outcast and be the backlash. You guys can't hear it. It's just in our headphones. I'm playing it right now, but copyright.
I'll sing it to you.
Is it good?
I don't know the words. She has
no.
Lyrics up.
Nothing's gonna hurt you the way the words do when they settle near your skin. Keep on the inside, no sunlight.
So anyway,
yeah.
I think she's underappreciated.
Wait, wait for the chorus. Go to the chorus.
Right here.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What
happen if you say what
she
sings
that?
Say, and let the words fall out. Yeah, you the high stuff, I'll get low.
Yeah, so that's Sarah Bareilles. That's not even my favorite song of hers, but that album, very good.
Yeah, I didn't know that she sung
that was good.
Song, so.
That's a good fade. You see how you fade? That's how you get it done. All right, I'm gonna start with my next one.
Okay.
Did you not just go?
Yes, but we're gonna go shoo, like a boomerang. Bat.
Okay, we gotta hurry up.
Yeah, we're already at 10.
Yeah, people don't like long videos,
hey,
and you have to leave them.
You're gonna
minutes.
Have to stick around for the rest of my list because it's really worth it. I think number one, because mine goes in order. Number five, Sarah Bareilles. Number four. Shotgun.
Why are you doing number
like,
four?
Like
when
in
you
a
get
car?
Shotgun in a vehicle.
Shotgun.
Oh.
I'm calling it underappreciated because everybody, it's more
nobody
of the game
respects
that people
it.
Like appreciate. Like, oh, I said shotgun first. So
I called it. Yeah.
More, I called it.
You
so
called it, but I think
appreciate
it's,
the game
I think it's
of
whoever
winning.
Gets to the car door first.
No, it's calling
that's
it.
Another conversation, but I agree. I think calling it, but you have to be an eye shot of the vehicle. You can't call shotgun for tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah. True, true, true.
But I think people appreciate the game of shotgun because it's a winning part of it. I appreciate getting a shotgun. I think it's underappreciated
you get a good
that
view.
You actually get in the front seat.
Yeah.
You're closer to the aux, you know,
you don't
and stuff
see
like
the
that.
Back of a seat the entire car
you're
ride.
Not crammed because usually there's more people in the back seat.
I don't think people respect it.
It's underappreciated. Like, don't change my list.
I know, but you were calling it.
It's not disrespected. It's
underappreciated. No, I don't think people respect the calling of it. Like, ooh, I'll say, oh, I get shotgun. And then I get out.
And then Bryn races to the door and says, I touched it first.
And I'm like, that's not how it's played.
Couldn't agree more.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. Next one.
Okay. What is next? Let's see.
You guys, I worked on this at like midnight last night.
You say it.
Yeah.
Say it in the
mic.
Say
it. 2018 Gerritsen football.
Underappreciated?
It is. We need to relive those glory days.
They were fun to coach.
They were good in 2018.
They were so good. Actually, that's when Clay played. Yeah. 62.
Clay Lardy?
My brother.
Oh, yeah. Monty.
62, best sideline.
Are you guys talking 2018 or 2016?
18.
No, that was, 2018, 2019. Yeah, I was just going off of seniors, which Mark Rattenberg and Marc-Jean Vandersnick and Keyshawn, they were all 2018 graduates, yeah.
Yeah.
But 2019 Play. Team? Yeah. Yeah, I think the other team was better.
2018?
2017, 18 team.
Yeah.
Did we make it to quarterfinals?
I think.
Or semi, I think quarter.
Because is that when Keyshawn got hurt?
That would have been the year before.
Oh.
But no, who did they lose to? Well, we'll have to look that up.
We
Stay
will,
tuned
but
for past Garrettson athletics.
Like compared to our football team now, they're so unappreciated.
Underappreciated.
Underappreciated.
Yeah.
Compared to now,
you miss them.
I
that
do.
Longing for it.
Like
type
I,
of thing.
When
yeah.
I was there at the games, I was on the hill, you know, at the football field. I was at the hill. Wasn't even watching it. And now that I have this football team, I wish that
Ouch,
I did watch
that was
it.
Rude.
Sorry.
That was
you
a
guys
very,
are trying hard. You guys are trying
very,
your best.
It was a very good
a
football
for
team.
Effort.
Yeah, it was a very good football
it
team.
Was a,
Maya,
yeah.
Underappreciated. Next one.
Getting something, like, when it's stuck in your teeth, getting, like, it out of your
Released.
Teeth. Yes.
Released.
Yeah. Popcorn kernel?
Yeah.
Oh, if one's, like, stuck in your gum.
And, like, I have braces, so stuff gets stuck in my teeth, like, too often.
I don't think
often.
People appreciate that feeling.
Like, when you have a chunk, like, you're eating steak or whatever, and you get something in your tooth.
Yeah.
And then it, like, slips out, and you're like, ooh, because it's so tight
it's
in there.
The when you best get when you get corn from corn on the cob stuck in between your teeth, that's a different
if,
type of
If
relief.
We're just
going
to go off of things that are underappreciated with the teeth, I think it's underappreciated someone telling you there's something in your teeth.
Yeah.
I don't think people know how much so. I appreciate when they say, you got a piece of pepper right here. And I'm like,
yeah, I'd rather have
I ate 7 hours like, ago.
Uh-huh. Or if you have like sauce on your face and they're like, hey, you got a little something here.
Yeah, it's underappreciated how much I appreciate someone telling me that.
Yeah. Bryn.
Kassidy.
Kassidy.
Waking up before your alarm.
You Googled all of these because I saw this list.
So hey, you looked some up too.
Well, it got my none of mine came from a list. It just got my brain.
That
gone.
Is not underappreciated. That's aggravating.
No, when you wake up before your alarm, like, oh my gosh, when you wake up at 4 a.m. And your alarm's set for like 6:30, you're like 2.5 hours?
No, I'm still
is
mad
that how
either
you feel
way.
About it?
Yeah. Unless I have to pee though.
Yeah.
No, but like if it woke me up like 5 minutes before my alarm, my alarm.
Oh, yeah.
Or no, I just woke up 5 minutes before my alarm, I'd be mad.
So it's more or less a time frame.
Or when your mom or dad wakes you up like 2 minutes before your alarm goes off.
Oh,
that's
so annoying.
Aggravating.
So if it's more time before your alarm, like when you feel like, oh my gosh, is it 6? And then you look and it's 4 and you're like, oh my gosh, I get a lot more hours of sleep. Yeah, I like that.
No, I don't like any of it because then I can't fall back asleep.
Like last night, I woke up to Lincoln. And I thought it felt like 4 o'clock in the morning, and it was only 12:45. And I was like, "Oh, this is great," you know what I mean? What was with the face?
I get annoyed when I wake up like that.
Well, when you wake up when you wake up like 3 times a night, like maybe that's when you'll start to acknowledge it. Why are you making faces? Okay, Brent.
Just continue.
Warm laundry, fresh out of the dryer.
Ooh.
I think that's
or a warm blanket, and then your mom goes and lays it on you.
Yeah.
Underappreciated.
That is actually my favorite.
That's a pretty good one.
It's so amazing.
It
I love like, it. You grab all of your laundry out of the dryer, and you just, like, want to just
you
lay
just lay
on
down
it.
Underneath
yeah.
of it. Yeah.
Or, like, your mom, like, ooh, washes everybody's blankets, and she grabs yours, and you sit on the couch, and she goes.
Why are you sitting like this on the couch?
I'm a dog. But, and it's like the dead of winter, and she puts a blanket on you, and you're like.
So like, I should—that's what I should get in my room, a dryer, and then some blankets, and then you
or
guys
like
can just
have those. Or like a towel warmer.
Yes.
A towel warmer.
Underappreciated. I like that one. Go another one. You got another one?
Oh yeah. Hold on. We've done
like two. Yeah.
Okay. We're at 16 minutes.
Calculators. I think they're so underappreciated. Like they're so useful, but nobody I think takes the time to like realize how useful they actually are.
I appreciate my calc. I've had it since middle school.
Me too. My pink one. I've had that baby for a while.
I maybe I'll just say my calculator app on my phone is underappreciated.
Okay, whatever.
I use that a lot.
Can that do decimals and fractions?
Yeah, it can. If you know how
fractions.
Okay. Cassidy.
Yeah, okay. That's what I thought.
This one's a little more personal opinion, but fall weather.
Yeah. I would. Chilly. I just about put on mine.
Chilly.
Or soup.
The changing of seasons. As underappreciated. Like, I really like when I go from chili. It's hot, and then all of a sudden I wake up in the morning and it's 45 degrees, 55 degrees outside, and it's got that, like, I need a sweatshirt. I agree with
I'm
you
not, like,
that.
Absolutely
a little sweater, I love it.
Right, but then I do appreciate when all of a sudden you have one of those days when it was cool out in the spring and it's, like, a hot day all of a sudden. I don't like hot weather a lot, but that one day where I'm like, oh, this feels nice.
Like, or when, like, when it's, like, 60s in South Dakota in the wintertime. I appreciate that.
Yes, like that, where you're like, oh, I'm going to wear my shorts today. Mm-hmm. Yeah, not to school.
Or like it's like the dead of winter, and you flash back.
That's the second time you've used dead of winter.
Okay.
Can it just be winter, or does that have to be
no,
the dead of
dead,
winter?
No, dead, like negative 30, and you do a little flashback to fall when the leaves were changing.
Okay.
And you're just like, oh, I wish I could go back to that.
When your pets greet you when you come home from, like, a vacation or something.
And their butts wagging.
Yeah.
Is that? I don't have any pets, so.
I have three
would
dogs.
Would that be underappreciated, or would it just be I don't know how to appreciate it.
That's underappreciated.
I have three
for sure.
dogs,
that
and they will
like
all
a
just like
problem.
Bombard you if they know who you are, and they just yeah. love you.
My dog tries to bite my face off.
Next one.
Ooh, what do we have? Mm-hmm. We have high school students. I don't think that we're appreciated
suck up,
enough.
Suck up.
Suck up to who?
High school students are underappreciated?
Yeah.
Okay, I just went off yesterday about how much I appreciated
yeah,
how
you did, but nobody else
in the
does.
Last couple weeks and how different it was yesterday.
Hey, we're back.
Okay, but think about,
today.
Like, all the stuff that we have to do.
I don't think you are underappreciated. I think you are overappreciated.
What? Over?
Yesterday
we have
you were.
No. So many classes, so much homework for all of them. Then teacher's like, oh, yeah, we have to grade all that stuff. Yeah. You have the answer key.
They think we don't have a life
have,
outside of school.
We have three quizzes in one day.
I don't know how to take it when you guys say they and I'm sitting here. Like, is it?
Well, not
you.
Don't give us quizzes. Like
count.
Math yeah. class.
I gave you homework today.
None of us
and
did.
Then you guys all did it before you got here.
Like, all the homework and stuff. And then. Some people like to get mad at us when we don't understand things.
Okay.
And we're trying
our
hardest.
I'm going to disagree with that one.
We're trying our hardest.
I appreciate you guys when you have good
Thanks,
attitudes.
Thanks. But
okay,
other people
I have
don't.
To go. So I'm going to give you guys my 3-2-1. And you guys can wrap this up with however
oh,
you want.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. Give
out
that headset.
Maybe Miss McGee can, yeah, maybe she can come and give yeah. one or something like that. Okay. So my number 3, underappreciated, the cold side of the pillow.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Like, I'm always flipping
so
pillows.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really flip pillows, but I get it.
Yeah. Yeah. I think it's talked about, but it's not really appreciated yeah. how great that feels. Mm-hmm. Number 2, maybe this is underappreciated for me because I haven't gotten to this point in a long time, getting the giggles or laugh until you cry type of a thing. I don't
yeah,
know. Last time I've gotten the giggles,
that,
and I wish I could.
Like,
I
could Mr. Mullen brings class yeah. every single day.
Or, yeah. like, when you stay up really late with your friends or whatever and you get, like, the zoomies.
Yeah.
You don't
like
know what the zoomies are?
And like the gig, like you,
like gummy worms?
You don't have a dog, everything. Never mind. Like your dog just gets like zoomies and just runs around
oh,
all the time.
Yeah,
but like
just
you
can't
get
stop
that.
Running.
Or
I have
giggling
three boys
and laughing.
That get the zoomies every night.
Yeah.
So.
Or you just think everything's funny.
Yeah, but that's
like that.
I don't remember the last time I got in the giggles.
The giggles.
Maybe it just makes me sad.
The last time I had the cool. giggles was Monday during the team meal when we were watching my video.
So yeah.
Everybody go watch it. Cooking with Cass.
Cooking
it's already
Cass.
Up.
By Episode the way, it's one. On. I have the artwork is on the TV channel. Cooking with Cass.
Gosh.
Yeah. So Kay. People know about it. My number one, I think, is more underrated, but I put it as my underappreciated list, is spicy sweet chili Doritos.
Those what? Are good. Those
no,
are good.
I don't really
oh, I think
like
I think cheddar jalapeno Cheetos are underrated.
Spit it out.
Or underappreciated.
I don't really like them
okay,
actually.
Cheddar jalapeno Cheetos I think are the best.
Okay. He's gone. We're running this show.
I don't like the way it makes your breath
I need
smell.
It makes your breath smell, Turn. But I don't care. I'll just brush my teeth afterwards. I like them too much.
Or throw in a piece of gum.
Yeah. I like
okay.
them too much.
We should okay, let's go with our list and then we'll go back around. And we gotta hurry up. So give your your favorite one, okay?
Oh.
Does everybody know their one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's our one? Women. You say, oh. You pick one. You pick one. I don't care. Addie's trying to figure out which one is our favorite. We have a really long list.
Can I go then?
Yeah, Bryn, take it away.
Okay, my number one is When Strangers Smile at You. I think it's just like a nice little gesture.
Yeah.
And I do think it's very underrated.
You know what else? You know what else? When somebody waves at you in the car.
Yes. Yes. Like yes. A nice little.
Not like a whole, but like a little. Yeah, that's good. Wave. Cass?
Having a pair of jeans.
Mike.
Sorry. Having a pair of jeans that have a big pocket.
Ooh, especially front pocket.
Or jeans that fit you perfectly. Because mm-hmm. I swear you can never find jeans that
And they're not like too tight, and so you can eat in them.
And you just look great in them.
Yeah, that's perfect.
This isn't my number one, but it's like one of my top ones. When you get like brand new like acrylic nails on.
And scratching your head?
Yes. When you're showering and like,
oh my gosh, yes, yes. And just the way that they look, like they're not grown out. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. Okay, Adam, what's our number one?
Our number one is going to be texting and calling.
That, yeah.
That's pretty underappreciated. Like,
that is.
I don't know how to explain it.
But like, just getting a call. Like, imagine the olden days when you had to write a letter.
The olden days.
Writing a letter, that's crazy.
And if your mom needs you for one thing, she can call you or text
or,
you.
Or, yeah, texting. Can't. You have all the receipts in text.
Oh, yeah.
And, like, you can send pictures over text. You can, FaceTime. Underappreciated. Underappreciated. FaceTime is so good. I love FaceTime. What?
Okay, wait. Nori, can I go back to what you said about the head massage thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Taking your hair out of a hairstyle after a long day and then scratching your head.
Yeah.
And it's like, feels so good.
Or when you have like a ponytail in and it looks good so you can't do anything about it, but it's pulling that one piece of hair and you take it out and it's like, oh. That is actually the best feeling ever. Okay. Are we? That was our list.
I think we are good, yeah.
Yeah, that was our list of our favorite things.
Unappreciated.
Our favorite underappreciated things.
Yeah, so thank you for watching. And
have a great day.
We will see you next time.